everyone! Sam and I are so happy you like our channel. We wanted to say a big thank you for all the thumbs up and comments.
Sam,
where are your manners? I'm talking to our subscribers.
Yeah. Hi! Look, I really need a phone to play Pokemon Go!
Sam, have you been sleeping for 2 years? Nobody plays that now.
I was told this app shows you where candies are hidden.
What candies, Sam? It's for collecting Pokemons.
It is? Well, I could use a few Pokemons for my collection, and you can give me candy.
Here, and you'll do without the phone. We're going to do something more interesting today. To honor the fact that we have recently reached 300,000 subscribers today, I'm going to show you one crazy science experiment.
Slime?
No, we've done slime already. Guys, do you think we should make another video about making slime? Vote in the poll, and we'll consider that.
So it'll be something boring again.
No, it won't. We're going to make hot ice.
Wow, just for slime safety purposes, I need to make sure hot means not cold.
Not cold at all, Sammy.
Go on, make it then.
First of all, I'll put on the gloves. Guys, no matter what experiments you make at home, always remember, safety is first. We'll start with the main ingredient, sodium acetate. I have this glass bottle, and I'll pour the substance in, like this, very carefully. I need to make sure nothing sticks to the bottleneck. We need to leave a few crystals. We'll need them later. Sam, what are you doing?
Adding some coloring to make sure the ice is interesting.
No way! It's a very delicate process. Even a speck of dust can ruin it.
Ugh! And I think somebody just likes bossing me around.
What's that, Sam?
A thank you for my fans.
You mean our fans.
Sue, sweetie, face the truth. You can bathe in the rays of my glory, but you can't replace the sun. Right, guys? Give the glorious Sam a thumbs up.
Off you go, Sam. Okay, with a dropper, I'll add a few drops of water into the bottle like this.
Maybe some coloring?
No. Guys, if you make this experiment at home, ask an adult for help. Let's take a small saucepan and place a folded towel on the bottom. We'll add some water. That's enough. And place it on low heat.
Are you cooking a towel?
Oh yes, it goes great with cheese, my favorite.
You're weird.
Okay, the water's boiling now. I need to place the bottle into the pan and loosely cover it with the lid. Okay, so next is the only boring part. You just need to stir the bottle every 2 minutes until the substance dissolves completely. You need to do it about 10 times.
A 100 million years have passed.
You know, I wish you'd help me instead of just hanging around and making fun of me.
Yes, yes, I can help! What?
Go make the word thank you out of candies.
Piece of cake.
Without eating a single one.
Mission impossible!
All right, the acetate has completely dissolved. I'll take the bottle out of the pan, close it, and leave it to cool. Done!
Sue, I'm done!
Sam, why did you only use one letter to spell the word you?
Oh, leave me be!
The bottle has cooled down. Hey, Sam, are you ready to see hot ice? That's a weird costume. What are you supposed to be?
I'm a mad scientist.
Oh, sorry.
You should apologize by giving me a candy.
Candies can make your teeth fall out. But I'll entrust you with the final most important step of the experiment.
I can't do it. What's the task? Get a philosopher's stone. Now. Make unicorn poop. No? Break into the Pentagon and steal a secret formula. Now?
Throw the crystals into the bottle.
Oh, no, too much responsibility. Do it yourself, and I'll tell you when. And fire!
Look, Sam, just like real ice.
Holy cannoli now! That's what I call an experiment. Why is it called hot ice?
The bottle has heated up. You want to check?
Oh, yes!
Sam, you should have used a glove. Are you a mad scientist again?
A third-degree burn.
Oh, I warned you. You should be very careful with the experiments. But I've got one more experiment for you.
And the poor slime will suffer again.
No, not if he follows the safety rules. For the second experiment, we'll need another bottle of acetate prepared the exact same way. I've already made it, so we can get onto the experiment. I'll place the crystals on a dish.
Add a bit of coloring!
Sam, I'm gonna send you away and show the experiment only to our viewers.
Fine, fine, just kidding.
I'll open the bottle and... Oh!
Oops, something went wrong!
Yes, I'm ready. Here! I'll open the bottle and pour the solvent carefully onto the crystals.
So look, it's growing! Ice is growing!
Yes, Sam. In nature, these things are called stalagmites.
Not stalagmites, stalactites. In the Tipidabo Caves, they kept falling down and damaging my candy snowdrop crops.
Well, stalactites are the ones that grow downwards, and stalagmites grow up.
Are there things that grow sideways?
Huh, I don't know, Sam. Guys, did you know the difference between stalagmites and stalactites? Leave your vote in the poll. And if you liked our video, subscribe to the channel for more incredible experiments and crafts from Sam. Bye!
This coloring won't ruin anything, only make it better. Flush! Splash! Hello, nothing's happening! Hello, it's the ball! Yeah! And... Oopsie. Maybe another time.